the most news in the morning. CNN's American Morning, weekday 6 a.m. Eastern.
Truth be told, you'd be hard-pressed to find a town more in need of economic stimulus than Braddock, Pennsylvania. It was the site of Andrew Carnegie's very first steel mill, a thriving industry town of about 20,000 people. Now, just 3,000 remain. Unemployment is sky high, and on Sunday, the town's biggest employer will close. The mayor of Braddock, John Fetterman, joins us now from Pittsburgh. Wow, did I overstate the case there, John? Is that what it's really like there?
No, you... absolutely not. In fact, the biggest employer, which is the University of Pittsburgh Medical Center, they're closing their hospital in town, and not only will we be losing jobs, we'll actually be losing our access to health care for many residents as well.
So sketch out the economic situation there. You know, how are folks doing? What's the unemployment level compared to the national average?
Our unemployment average typically tracks about 2.5 to 3 times above the national and the county average. So we're comfortably in the 30s there. And that, of course, doesn't factor in the more recent development of the many jobs that will be lost by the hospital closing this Sunday.
Right. So you've gotten some stimulus money. How much have you gotten? Where has it been going to? And how much has it helped you, if at all?
Well, it has helped a great deal. We got about $250,000 to upgrade our sewer system to be in compliance with the Environmental Protection Agency. Not terribly particularly sexy kind of things or headline grabbing, but still necessary mm-hmm. in a community like Braddock, where we're unfortunately looking at having to raise property taxes because of the revenue loss when the hospital leaves. And then we also got a much smaller grant, about $30,000, which allowed us to hire an additional 30 young people last summer, which was, again, very beneficial, too.
But, you know, I saw you on television almost a year ago now saying, hey, we've got shovel-ready projects, we've got green mm-hmm. projects that we could use money for. Have you gotten any money to fund those projects?
No, and absolutely, that's an excellent point, and that kind of brings me to what I believe about the stimulus funding, that its greatest potential, I think, could lay ahead in funding these kind of projects and new ones that arise quickly. You mm-hmm. know, when UPMC bailed on our town, we have now left a 300,000-square-foot hospital in town that is going to be vacant in about 4 days. So these are the kind of issues that towns across the country are dealing with, and we need that kind of quick, responsive deployment of resources to help us not get back on our feet, but yeah. just kind of maintain where we're at now. So it's a very serious situation.
Mr. Mayor, about 200 of your colleagues met with President Obama last week, and one of the messages that they had to him about the stimulus package was, hey, all the money's being given to the states for them to dole out as they see fit. Why not bring it down to the municipal level, give it directly to cities, give it directly to towns? What do you think of that idea? Would that help?
Amen. That would be tremendous. I'd be more than happy to compete on the merit of the ideas and the projects that we have, not only in Braddock, but in Allegheny County. We have quality, as I mentioned, shovel-ready projects that could be a real shot in the arm to not only my town, but also the region as a whole, which really suffered greatly. And then when you consider the amount of resources that went to the banking bailout, and the amount of resources that went to areas like Braddock, there's just a grotesque disparity. And I think that's part of the thing that needs to happen in order to bring the country back around this administration's agenda.